All right, YouTube, we are here at Blue Ox Trains in Roswell, Georgia. I think I got that right. Anyways, Roswell, Georgia. I do have Mr. Peanut Gallery here, too. But so it's half of what is apparently also an antique store. But if y'all are in the area, then I would very highly recommend you guys visit. Because there is a very good smattering of hard-to-find stuff, older stuff, that you just don't see. They got a pretty good selection of sound chips, including a bunch of the brand-new Pico Unifrog turnouts, including a double slip, a whole bunch of the old Code 100, a bunch of these Tsunami 2, including the newer 2200s. You could tell Rich and I have been busy. And then I have my goodies in there, which that will show up in a later video. It's a brass, so that's all the teasing I'll give you. But there's a pretty good selection of Digitracks. There's miscellaneous stuff like Tenshindo Brass, FAs, United Brass, 080. And here's the other thing. The guy takes estates. I want to compliment both of the owners on the prices. So, for a Southern 280, $195, that's pretty good. The brass model I picked up was, he had $170. He went ahead and lowered it to $160 for me. And this thing runs. There's no grind in the motor. There's no bucking sound from any of the gears. None of the wheels are out of quarter. It's fantastic shape. So for 170, that down to 160. He's doing actual, he's not doing collector prices, so, which is phenomenal. But just miscellaneous stuff. We got some O-gauge. He's got Digitracks. So even has LNY, some of the newest turnout decoders, some of the newer throttles, etc., etc. Whole bunch of locomotives. We got some Norfolk Southern stuff down there. We've got Paragon 2 steamers, which I didn't even look at these. Ooh, DL-109s and a light Mikado. There's even an old Blue Line box. And MDF-3s, Oriental Limited. Dang, I did not notice those. Crud. I missed your Oriental F3 units. Got more over here. Some of this stuff is DCC equipped. So yeah, Bachman with sound, 189, that's pretty good. 109.45 for an FP45 with sound, again, pretty darn good. Just miscellaneous stuff in here. I don't see this many odds and ends at even train shows. So a couple signals, semaphores, shop mascot, best part of the store. Books. There's a whole lot of bar mills, kits, craftsmen, wood buildings. We got figures. A whole bunch of like just miscellaneous detail parts. Walters buildings, cornerstone. A whole lot of bar mills, craftsmen, wood kits. All that sort of stuff. Display layout, which I will get to in a minute. We're going to work our way back up to it. Just, I mean, miscellaneous engines. A really old pair of UPFs. I mean, old locomotive kits. I mean, there's a brass Aristocraft Casey Jones for 74. So, good prices. It's got a whole bunch of Bachman Easy Track, Micro Scale, Micro Sol, even some of the testers, which is getting really hard to find. We've got tap and drill sets. We've got a whole bunch of Excel, Katie couplers. I mean, just miscellaneous, like steel beam square, mountains of windows, detail parts, express mail scale, which I didn't see that. I'm going to have to come back for that when we visit my aunt in December. even a little bit of wiring stuff. Wire and just like miscellaneous parts all over the place. Signs. A bunch of like old Woodland Scenics cast metal kits. Just a lot of, really cool knickknacks. Pretty good selection of trucks. Some Atherton parts. I think there's just a bunch that he's out of because they're empty hooks. But, I don't see parts very much. Got a good selection of lubricants, plenty of hobby lube. Lock an easy track. And then if we swing around here, you got some of your ground foam, snow ballast, more Woodland Scenic stuff, stuff like some bridge piers, some rock wall moldings, cork. Good selection of N-scale. He's got A3 and 55 and N. N-scale cork, HF-scale cork. Pico bridge track, which was in Code 100, which was very surprising. Code 100, A3, Atlas, a whole bunch of the Walthers, pre-lit landmark buildings. Just keep going around. We got cars, a bunch of intermodal stuff. He does a lot of estates and collections, so like there's a whole bunch of Union Pacific in here now, and that's all from an estate that is the guy slowly coming in and parsing out. So we got a whole bunch of like all the water effects, even a couple display cases, turf, ground foam, static grass applicator, super trees, miscellaneous trees, we got plastic cloth, everything else, just a whole bunch of that. Earth coat. There is even a whole section of N-scale. So like N-scale buildings, bunch of N-scale rolling stock, bunch of Kato unit track and then Atlas track. Joiners, a few scale trains things. And we've got a whole bunch of like N-scale loads. More buildings. There's even some polyscale and testers paint left around in here. Model master. Some of the O stuff kind of scattered around in here. Gargaves track, Lionel fast track. Like just another random thing with polyscale paint. Again, that's something else that's getting hard to find. Whole half of it that's all antiques. Miscellaneous electronics, stuff like lamps, LEDs, ground throws, 8-position terminal box, $3 each. A bunch of the older paints. There's even a bunch of the Floquill railroad colors that are basically gone. Whole corner here with a whole bunch of O gauge, a bunch of the older Varney Tyco. There's some ON30 there, some antique stuff mixed in. We even got, and these caught my eye. I didn't end up getting either one of them because they sound like they both had issues, but we got two Rivarossi Red Box engines. I also think I have that number in the two-tone gray. An Athra Mikado, a Proto 2000, a Union Pacific 2882, snowplow, a couple airplane models, some more just miscellaneous scenery stuff, a good selection of books, videos, VHS, DVDs. Here's another thing I really want to compliment this shop on. Usual fare, Atlas track, but you get down here, this is where it gets interesting, folks. He's got boxes and it's just completely random tracks. So yeah, there's Atlas, But there's a lot of this. I mean, this is old Code 3 Walter Shinohara. Like, by the tie design, this is some of the really, really early stuff that, oh, it's not DCC friendly. Peninsula of Rails, where is it? Anyways. You know, and it's in pretty good shape. I mean, yeah, one of the headblock ties is missing, but all the major stuff is there, and even that's easy to fix. Just put some PCB ties. I mean, there's that, there's track, there's even some of these old, which again, these would be fine too. You know, Anderson HO Nickel Silver Turnout Kits, just put that on some Code 100, just stick that on some PCB ties. You know, on a fast track jig, you know, I'm wanting $6.95 for it. Again, that's a pretty damn good price. And, like, you know, I'm coming back, so I'm going to end up getting a bunch of those for Redstone. Not for Redstone, for the museum. I mean, just miscellaneous track. There's some transition pieces in there. I mean, there's some older Pico. Just mixed up. I mean, like electronics. And then this is what really floored me. A whole box of older Shinohara. That's all in pretty good shape. There's the fur ball again. So, pretty good. And then we'll swing over to this side. First, a bunch of scratch belt stuff in here. He built himself, so none of this is for sale, but he built all this, scratch built. You know, it's... very impressive. Pretty, really, really good selection of engines. I mean, there's a whole bunch of Kato stuff in here right now. And the prices on this is like... I mean, RS2, you know, so on and so forth. Yeah, so there you go. Okay, that doesn't show up, but like, you know, for an SDP Atheron DCC ready, $60. That's right about where it should be, from what I've seen at train shows. And just, like, more buildings, we got some more diesels. Again, I came in here and I about drooled, because Union Pacific, you know, that really kind of was hard to... ignore. Because as most of you who watch the channel know, I picked the Hawking because I'm a steam fanatic, but I'm also, my other favorite is Union Pacific. And this miscellaneous carloads. I didn't notice this before. Oh, damn, the guy's got motors. I mean, look at this. Which I'm assuming are all tested and work. With 25 marketplace. Motor parts not complete, but, you know, $10. I mean, hopper loads, coal loads, a whole bunch of Bowser hoppers. So, like, we got, you know, a 4-bay clinch field. That's probably about air appropriate for the museum. A bunch of older, really cool stuff like the train miniature. Multi-pack, and it's okay. I'm gonna keep working my way out here. You got some more miscellaneous vehicles and stuff, some Atheron Pensy cars, which look phenomenal, and then about the biggest selection of P2K stuff I've seen in a while. Some of the newest Genesis stuff. I mean, there's a whole bunch. E8s, E9s, Jeep 7s, Jeep 30s. There's Jeep 20s in here. I mean, flip it over there. There's ST60s. You know, FA2. I got a kick out of this, guys. Custom paint. So, $125. That's maybe a little high, but... just miscellaneous. So a bunch of miscellaneous cars just all over the wall. Blue Ox Trains, folks. Roswell, Georgia. I'm kind of just hanging. We've got, again, more stuff down there. I mean, there's a Tenshindo diesel locomotive. F7B dummy needs repairs, both of them. $22. I mean, that's pretty darn good. Just a bunch of... There's a bunch of older rolling stock all stashed through here. I mean, there's a whole bunch of the older CB&T car shops, Varney, Globe. He does have a test track, so you can test stuff. He's got all three O-gauge, DC, and Digitrax. There's a whole bunch of lifelike whatnot up top. There's a huge passenger section mixed in Overton car kit. I mean, like, this, I got a kick out of this too, guys. Really, really Walters kit and some Rio Grande Doodlebug. I mean, that's, you know, I love it. Just more miscellaneous rolling stock, some rather nice Union Pacific cabooses. And which those UP people, you'll know what exactly I'm talking about. Some stuff that is dead nuts on era appropriate for the 50s. Just miscellaneous. I mean, we've got longer stuff here. Drop bottom gondolas, Santa Fe baggage kits. A bunch more passenger cars down there. If we flip around real quick, there's even a couple of train sets. We got a bunch of Plastistruck. I mean, there's circus train kits. I have never seen that stuff. $8 a pop, a bunch of the old Ricks twin coils with the contacts. Some more of this. Again, just continuing on. I mean, there's a bunch of River Rossi. This is all passenger cars and just different miscellaneous freight cars. We got some Walters over here. And little stuff like this, guys. Have a look at this. Oops. Okay, I did not mean to do that. Yeesh. Okay, let's try a different one. But stuff like this. An old vintage metal car. It's got Katie's and it's got Central Valley trucks on it. And these are some of the really, really good passenger car trucks. Some of the best you can buy. Springs. I mean, obviously this was custom done. It's got diaphragms on the end of it, you know. There's even some Centralia car shops, Union Pacific cabooses, which... Okay, give me a minute. I want to get this out and show you guys. Which I drooled over too, honestly. Oh, well, I can't get it. Whole bunch of miscellaneous power packs, including even some G-scale. I mean, Roundhouse, you know, Rio Grande Overland car kit. So, Amtrak couple of these. I mean, just miscellaneous. And then over here, we've got a whole bunch of Walters, Atlas, Intermountain. On the far shelf, we even got some Katie's. And these are for sale, but I love the display. I mean, we're 30s pre-war template up on top. And if we keep working our way down here, we've got just more miscellaneous. A pretty good collection of N-scale rolling stock. Some more scratch-built buildings that are actually for sale. And then we have the store layout. And they're playing 70s music, which is pretty cool, so.
I'm serious.
Kato SD80 Max. He's weathered all the stuff himself. His home, his modules. That's awesome. Rotating pole with Hallmark. On it.
I have a whole bunch of 50 and 100 foot containers and reels.
That's up over there. I'll light this other. Bunch of stuff right there. It's not for sale. And then the other whole half of it and the upper floor is all antiques. So, yeah. This is Blue Ox Trains at Roswell, Georgia. And if you're in the area, come have a look, guys. This is a pretty well-stocked hobby shop. So, as always, you know, do a comment, like, subscribe, hit the bell icon. Take care, God bless, and yeah, I'll see y'all on the next video.